I am that I am. Ilya of free and sovereign domain, in service of truth. And so you are all too. I like, first of all, today to express my special joy and my extraordinary pleasure to explain to all why this happens in this country, that the truth comes first of all in this holy land, Holland, Holland, because that is the country of the highest standards of freedom. There are many who would probably disagree with me, but I feel that, and I know that many who are judging differently your highest freedom standards are not knowing that the higher DNA level than only 12 are also possible, and probably, what if they are next step in the evolution of human beings? Who said that we are limited? We are deciding about ourselves. So, and that's why here in this holy land, and probably why Ilya, why the truth comes through me, and that is also simple to explain, because when I started my spiritual expansion, so to say, my spiritual journey, went out of the box and started experiencing other reality. Actually, I know now that it's the only one. Then I heard in my meditations, I heard the call. And trust me, the call was so clear, like you hear now my voice. And the call was so clear, asking, who dares to bring the truth to this planet in these transitional times? And I embraced immediately that challenge, because I know, and I knew, that there are no problems, there are only challenges to grow up, to expand, and to evolve. All the challenges are gifts, and I embraced that gift and went into the an adventure of the huge changes in my life. But I'm thankful to that. Everything that it happened, like it happened, I know there is a good in everything, and I bless that everything. And together with you, we all are now the group of people who is bringing truth to this civilization, truth about creational laws, about nature, about human being, about life, about sense of life, truth about evolution of this civilization through making the quantum leap I was talking last time, from the electrical awareness of our senses into the cosmic awareness of our mind. So I would like, in the future also, I believe, I would like to start my presentations with this wonderful picture. This is not from Ilya, this is from NASA. They took the picture somewhere in the cosmos. And that is wonderful picture, I love it, because it demonstrates the creational principle. You see, from both sides, rings, clearly recorded in the universe on a big scale, and in the middle, with a little bit perspective, but in the middle, you see the sun, the highest incandescence, and that is nicest demonstration and nicest proof of the creational principles that I have presented last time, that were also already known from Walter Russell and for Tesla and many others, but still not accepted in this civilization as the truth. So, today there will be actually two presentations. The first one is dealing with the application of the EULA concept in explanation of one experiment that made a huge impact in the physics in the 1960s. An experiment that was rewarded with Nobel Prize also, two young scientists, Li Yang in the, at the Columbia University in America, made an excellent experiment, and they have shown that atoms spin along the shaft, along the axis, and they inject two different kinds of particles on the two different sides. And there was a hope also that the model of atoms should be somehow as a screws, right-handed and left-handed, and on that base there was a hope to explain some mysterious forces which held atom from the inside. Later on you will see it is totally in opposition to the natural laws of creation. But never mind, this experiment is demonstration how easily senses can deceive us and bring conclusions which are total in opposition to that what is actually in the reality, what is happening in the reality, to the real laws of creation. But we now know the clue. The last time I said, whenever you find something in the science and you want to know the truth, you turn it upside down and you know the truth. And that's easy. That's easy. We now have the clue. We have the key. And they also have the key. Using the new EULA concept, it is very easy, and you will see, to explain that experiment itself was not needed for that purposes, because a little knowledge about electric current and little meditation and little logic would be enough to come to the right conclusion, and no need for that kind of experiment at all. At all. So our science is a full of big, big experiments, huge experiments. I contend that that big, big experiment in CERN could be made for high as 100,000 euros. And they have already invested billions of euros there. And the much better conclusions could be drawn out of those 100,000 euros on the new way, of course. So, I will go into the explanation step by step, and we'll first decide what was actually announced officially at that time, and will that comment everything in the light of the real knowledge. So, the first, a crystal containing cobalt nuclei was placed in a magnetic field. I put in the red everything what is interesting to draw your attention. Created by current flowing through a wire coil. It was already known that the cobalt nuclei would line up in the magnetic field. The first thing that is now clear, there are no magnetic fields. All the fields in that universe, in this universe of motion, are electric fields. One stationary, one still universe of the still magnetic here light is motionless. And everything what is motion is electric. That is the first wrong premise in this experiment. There was no created magnetic field, it was created an electric field. So, you know, and I have explained many times, that so famous magnets, bar magnets, or any other magnets, are actually electric bars, because two electric vortexes are sitting on the end of the bar, and we call it magnets. We must remove that from our head. So, that is the picture, how they made their coils. They made their coils cylindrically on the picture on the left, and you see on the picture on the left side, yes, you see here on the picture on the left side, cylindrical coils, and here an atom of cobalt injected from this side into the magnetic, they call it magnetic electric field, of course. And this is the way men devise stillness to produce the motions. On the right side, this is the way nature devise stillness to produce the motions. And you see the big difference. This coil is first of all cylindrical. And you have two anodes, this side, and one cathode, dividing equator. And I will show you later during the presentation why these conical coils and how to wind them and how to use out the power of the nature's principle of the multiplication of the motion as a tool to create something new and something very amazing. So the other thing to explain is that that experiment that happened at the Columbia University in America was not a local event, because no one event in this universe is a local event. There is that nature's radar system, which actually projects and reflects all over the world, the universe, every single moment, like this my finger, eternally repeating it. So this presentation right now is seen and heard from the farthest, farthest reaches of the universe and will be repeated eternally. So no one, because of the construction of that still magnetic universe, who is repeating every single motion eternally, so that everything what has ever happened is recorded and eternally repeating. So nothing in this universe of motion is created, because the cause that still the universe at rest is infinite and eternal, and the effect, this universe of motion, is also infinite and eternal.
Is that the morphogenetic field?
Sorry?
Do you compare it with the morphogenetic field?
Morphogenetic field?
Is that what you mean? That it, things repeat and keep forever in the memory of the field?
If you call it morphogenetic field, okay.
Okay, but it's the same what you mean.
Yes, of course. Okay. Yes, of course. So, that is provided by the well-known, now well-known, but unknown in the science, so-called avoidance principle. Avoidance principle is a logical consequence of the creation, because nothing except that universe at rest can exist. And it is only a reality that exists. And in the imagination, in the dream, in the thinking process, in the thoughts, we must create, as creators, all of us, we must create pairs so that they void each other as they appear, as they occur, and repeat as they void, and record as they repeat, and so eternal. That avoidance principle is quite new, but must be accepted into the science also. So this experiment is a nice example to explain how senses can deceive us easily. And only experiments who are in conformation with the nature's way of creation are valid experiments. From that point of view, Dick's experiment is not valid. It doesn't matter. I told you many times, life is about experiencing, but we are coming now into awareness, and we are becoming aware of it, and we are starting to live consciously and create consciously instead of habitually creating, trusting our senses and making always the not existing reality as real. Now we know not to trust our senses, but trust our mind who knows the truth. So, cylindrical coils that you have seen on that picture are not in conformation with the electric current. Only conical coils divide the stillness at the position in the middle where the cathode is, divide the stillness for the purpose of multiplying motion and concentrating and compressing it into the matter in order to heat to the incandescence the huge volume which is occupied by the rings and then expand that huge, that small piece of matter, incandescence, back into the universal vacuum, into the non-dimensional seed pattern, and repeating that eternally. So the coils, conical coils, cylindrical coils are inefficient, and the loop of forces that they created are not concentrated and are totally inefficient. And I'm talking that to you to make an aha effect and to stop working with cylindrical coils. I know many of you and some others who are not present this evening are working on devices and still using conical coils, cylindrical coils. Please think about conical coils. I will give you later advices how to create easy, simple with conical coils. So, until now, two essentials omitted for the perfect carrying of this experiment are failure to conform with the working principle of electric current, that the first, what is essential for the validity of our experiment, if it is not in conformity with the working principle of electrical current, you can forget it. And the other one is a little bit more complicated, a little bit more difficult to understand, making an electric field to conform with the mathematics of dividing and multiplying pressures. So the conical coils, not every conical coils are efficient in multiplying and heating and producing electric current. Only those who conform with so-called octave principle of multiplication are efficient. And I'll tell you later also how to build easy that. And show you also that the Tesla knew that and created with it also. And many of you have seen it, not recognizing it. Okay. So, go to the step three. Again, quote, the test was based on the previously proven fact that the nucleus of atom decays in the process of it emits an electron and electron, an uncharged particle even smaller than the electron. So very interesting, the first thing, that atom as a piece of matter decays is nothing new. All matter is actually discharging. Look at this. It was not necessary to prove that cobalt decays, means disintegrate, depolarize, means discharge and die. Since all matter does it, and the piece of matter known as a cobalt also does it. Experiment was not needed for that purpose. Sure. It was easy to. And the second is everything what they have done with that experiment, they have lined up the cobalt atoms with the gravity of shaft of the electric field. And that process is known as the polarization. And the opposite process of the polarization is the process of the emitting rings on the equatorial plane, and that is that are only two processes in the nature that are involved in the whole process of creation, cycle of creation. So, the statement that uncharged particles are ejecting from one end is also not true. The whole matter is a charged condition. So there are no uncharged particles in this universe of the motion. Motion is an electric effect which charges all matter. So as soon as you have the motion, you have charging process. So that is totally in opposition. So, going to the step four, according to the parity, I would like to remind you, parity is a well-known principle in the physics. That is the principle which means impairs the same, behavior the same. That is the parity. So, according to that principle of parity, even in this experiment, both sides, both ends of the cobalt atom in this cylindrical coil should have the same behavior according to the principle of parity. But because they found one side electrons, one electrinos, smaller and bigger particles, they concluded that that principle of parity was not valid. It was huge, 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 huge step in the physics discovery that the parity principle is not valid according to this experiment, which was totally wrong, created in the conclusions. As they spun, half of them should have emitted their electrons from the north and of the magnetic electric field, and the other half toward the south. Actually, far more electrons come out from the south end of the nuclei. By repeating the test under varying conditions, it was verified that cobalt nuclei emit electrons from one particular end. This shows that one end of the nucleus is different from the other, something never known before. That was a huge conclusion. And look now, I'll show you. So, you see, the fact that it was never known is an absurd, because the whole matter is a charged condition. So that one end is the different than the other end, that is totally natural. So it was known from the time since the electricity was known. That was the case. That one end inject bigger and one end the smaller particles, that is logical consequence of that. What cobalt atom is and what is its position in the wave amplitude in the appropriate octave in the periodic table for the periodic chart of elements of the Walter-Russell. So, now, yeah, it was not true, and the important fact that they have overlooked by their conclusions was that an unbalanced particle of matter, like cobalt, cannot emit equal potentials. It must emit different potentials because it is unbalanced. Cobalt is an atom which is predominantly blue, and it is not balanced. The center is very shifted from the geometrical center and totally unbalanced. Must emit different potentials from the different sides. It's a simple. You don't need experiment to prove it. It's a simple logic. It costs probably 2 minutes to think. So, the whole matter, according to the creational principle I have presented last time, begins by division of the stillness and projection into two wave motion into pairs of octave wave tones, which we call elements. That principle is the same as the nature's radar principle, and reduced to the simplicity, the nature is a series of echoes, and that is why everything what is motion is eternally repeated. You are familiar with that effect of echo. So, that is how it looks like on the end of the creator. That's Wolfram Russell. He calls creator God, and not me. I know the difference between that. So, it doesn't matter, you can hear. In every plane here, the rings, this plane, and this plane, there are three intersecting planes. In each plane, there are two-dimensional rings, and they are souls of the each piece of matter and souls of the creation. And how the hour and of the cosmic radar looks like, it creates sphere. It creates in the middle on the wave amplitude carbon atom as an ideal sphere, totally incandescent, an atom that is totally balanced carbon and that crystallized in cube. So, I'm not, because there is too much. So, it is also a picture that I have presented from Walter Russell the last time. But each piece of matter in this universe has an image which is called antimatter, which ultimately voids and reborns that piece of matter. Antimatter concept have their relation in the material images in the space geometry. But it must be so, because nothing except that eternal universe at rest is always existing. So matter and antimatter avoiding each other at each point of the evolution of the creational process. Okay. I will not go too much into details. So, I would like to stress that nature's principle of creation, which divides stillness into equal and opposite pairs, and multiplies those pairs until it heats a cold to the incandescence and close that black hole that is occupied by the rings. After that, that incandescence will be again expanded back, and that hole disappears that way. Like, just to underline that totally illogical and in the science accepted principle of the creation of the universe, that so-called Big Bang. That everything started from the small volume, which was exploded and expanded and so on. It's not true, of course. Truth is that billions and billions and billions of the small black holes always have been creating permanently, because the process of the creation begins with occupying huge volume of space and creating a hole, black hole, closing that black hole by incandescence and expanding it back into the still universe of the rest, into the non-dimensional seed pattern, and repeating that process again. So, to notice for you, for the practical applications, is an efficiency, inefficiency of the cylindrical coins, and no more need for evaluation of that inefficiency. There is the nature's way of creation with conical coils, and you are a group of people, and we as civilization will change all our technologies and throw out of the use cylindrical coils and use the conical coils. I know. So, how it is very easy to make logical conclusions. An unbalanced element can produce unbalanced effects. So if they have taken carbon or sodium chloride or any other element from that, if you remember from the last presentation, balanced kiss, those balanced pairs, they would have the same effect on the both sides. That's illogical. But they have taken one unbalanced element and got unbalanced particle on both sides. Totally logical, no need for experimentation. So that is from the last time. If they would have taken, you see how many balanced combinations, there are many, many, many that are all drawn here from the water result. And all those would have given one balanced effect. That's total logical. Every 10-year kid can understand it and say, yes, it's logical. Why should I experiment with it? That's the easy and the beauty of the knowledge and the change from the old science based on information, which is sense deception, and spring into the new science, which will be based on real knowledge and create simple, efficient, cheap, and easy new energy value. Electric bar, not magnetic bar, because it will be also changed. Nobody will be calling that more magnetic bars. They call electric bars. It's really two electric vortexes on the ends of the bar, and that is all. Nothing magnetic there. Step number six. It is claimed that the discovery of different ends to atomic particles and emissions on other particles from opposite ends gives to each emitted particle a spin in the direction of its motion. And that was one of the biggest conclusions, because spin in the direction of the motion would prove that motion is two-way because of the two ends of the conical coil, and which means existence of right-handedness and left-handedness. Sense deception, totally everything on the level of the senses. Right conclusions according to the wrong assumptions. I mean, opposite of the truth. To explain how it is impossible to have right and left-handedness, I don't believe that I need too much time to explain to you. The last time, but in my last presentation, I explained you on this wonderful example with apple. And you will remind yourself, always remember, that wonderful symbol of knowledge which was forbidden deliberately, even in Eden Garden. We know now why. But it's a game, life is game. We have experienced enough from that, and we want now to experience something new, to expand, to evolve, and experience unlimited potential. By the way, darkness, metaphorically, means lack of knowledge. And when you listen or read that we are kept in darkness, it means that the knowledge was deliberately cut off and hidden from us. Darkness is a symbol for the lack of knowledge. And that's what Jesus said, forgive them, they don't know. They don't know truth. But now we are coming in knowledge, and we are starting to know the truth. Of course, not from thoughts. Some more examples about the sense deception and about mind knowing, because all the effects of the one cause in this universe are an illusion and they do not exist. So up and down, right and left, and everything else, it is a little bit different, difficult to explain and to start to apply in our practical lives. But we start now to think that way and to create that way. You will have time to read it. I will make it a little bit shorter because there are some other things. And that's a wonderful example from that last time also, how easily to explain it, that there is no right and left-handedness. You go the same direction, not changing direction, you go way out like here, and you see that is a... oh, for the senses, you have two different directions, here that one, and all of you know now that is one direction. And the whole civilization will be teaching our kids in the schools, and this picture will go into all the books of the new educational system. It will start in this civilization. Yes. Okay, that I have already explained it, for it's here. And nature has one law of creation and applies that law for the smallest particle, interstellar, and for the whole universe. There is no difference. When atom is built, like a solar system, like a nebula, everywhere you have the same principle of creation. And that is simplicity, and whenever you come in your life to something that is so complicated or complex, think about it. It is not in accordance with Creator's principle, because Creator creates with simplicity. When you average the simplicity, you know that you are on the right track. Yeah, simplicity, because that illusion belongs to the senses, and our mind knows the truth and can correct that what our senses are delivering us and come into the truth, into knowledge. You can imagine easily that sun itself. I remind you on the process of creation. From one side, rings coming from other side, spinning in opposite directions, formally, for the senses, opposite direction, creating two hemispheres, and two hemispheres then build by prolating, build a sphere, which is then oblating and expanding equatorially back into the universe of the rest. So this universe is bilateral, which means there is one universe which is the cause and the other is up effect, B, two. And the whole motion spins around the shaft, not around the center. There is no force in the center which pulls in according to the Newton's principle of the gravity. There is always compression from the outside which compresses space into the matter to the incandescence. easy. They say that it's from inside. We turn that not upside down. It's from outside. Let me know the truth. We love them because they gave us simple principle how to come into the truth. Is that right? Huh? Okay. That is exactly what those two guys have done. They made the conclusion that there is spin in the direction of the axis, of the shaft. And we know that the spinning of the rings is in the planes which are 90 degrees to the direction of the shaft. That's easy, not big difference, but it's a truth. So, how illogically it would be, it would have been the true, what they have concluded, that the particles from this side spin in one direction along the shaft, that's a cobalt here, direction of the motion, windings here, and then those particles would have, according, if they, that was the truth, spin in one direction and the shaft normal to this shaft, and those particles on the other side, because according to them there were left-handed and right-handed particles, would spin this and would have this shaft, and those two shafts, additional shaft, would be totally illogical and would be normal to the shaft of the gravity, which is actually, I'd like to explain to you once again, when I get the chance, just let me see, when I get the chance to explain you once again what is gravity. That's simple. Look at me. Don't need to look there. Rings spinning from one side, from the other side, because the whole universe is a one point, one cutoff, as I have explained here. So, when the rings progress in their compressing phase or expanding phase, doesn't matter, we identify the center, the centering point of the rings as a gravity shaft. But each that point is the same point, because the whole universe of rest is a one point. And you cannot go out of that whole universe except in thoughts, in imagination. So gravity is that what seems to move for our senses, and what actually has nothing with motion. Andre, can you hold this? Stop there. Can you hold this apple? I throw off this apple to you and explain you. Andre, that's easy. Look at this, throw to me. And now, you per se, thanks, Andre, you per se, that this apple was moving to the Andre and moving back to the me. And your senses tell you that is direction of motion. Apple. In every other object in the universe, plane, everything. So, mind knows that what we see is identifiable point of the still universe, which is gravity shaft. But the motion itself is in planes 90 degree to this direction. And that is what mind knows. Sensing see that, mind corrects it and say, no. And mind knows once more. There is also, according to that what I explained you as antimatter, there is also antimatter, which voids this matter. And here, there is a time, backward flow in time also. And my mind knows now, there was no this motion to Andre of this apple and to me. Now comes the challenge for your mind. Just connect the dots. We have stated that the only, and for the mind, all this motion and this happening here does not exist at all. The only reality which exists is the mind itself, spirit itself. And that's it, only an illusion of the mind, imagination of the mind. And I am that still observer of this happening who knows that only as a mind experience, and all of you know. I believe that you start to grasp now, to understand the truth about sense deception and mind knowing. Because again, this apple didn't go there and didn't come to me. And this apple does not exist at all. Because at the very stage of creation of this apple, it is voided when it is a curse. It is repeated when it is voided, and it is recorded, and our senses perceive only forward motion of time and not the backward motion of time which voids it. So when you see the plane here and him flying, your mind knows there is the black hole behind that plane which voids that what you perceive as the motion, and those passengers do not fly to New York at all. Except for your and their and my senses. And my and your mind knows that there are souls who project that experience mentally. So the whole game here is a game. And people take life so seriously. Unbelievable. I'm so happy. Only when you respond that way, when you laugh, it means that you have grasped, understood it, and will then absorb it and apply in your lives. There is nothing serious in life. Of course. We are not going to threaten or bring in danger any freedom of any other being, but we want to experience and to enjoy our freedom. And that is possible. To respect freedom of each fly, smallest fly, not to kill it. Because it's with the purpose there. We want it. That's why. We are created of this earth. And then we come to the last step, step number 8. The conclusion is that the particle will be now referred as a right-handed and the left-handed, and that actually was a contrary to the principle of the parity, and that was proof that principle of parity is not valid. It was a big. Of course, big mistake from our point of view, but this experiment and those results were rewarded with Nobel Prize. At that time, they were good in the service of keeping us in darkness, of course. the better tool for keeping us in darkness, the higher reward, of course, the greater reward, the bigger reward. Look, huh? Okay, so that is what I have explained to you, very simple. You will have an opportunity to watch the video and to read it and to analyze it and to think about it and meditate, but in essence, that is what I have explained here. Very easy and very simple, and you will never forget that. This reading will take you some time to absorb. But I have to write it that way in order to enable the scientific world to read it, because they like that sophisticated way and exactness. And that is all here written in exact way as a base for showing them that we are really, really true, that we have right with our truth, with the truth. Yeah. I told you already that the whole universe is a cathode. Whole universe is a cathode. It's a source. Cathode will be divided, this is equator, into two opposite poles, and the anode will be created all over the universe. And now, just to come to that point, nothing moves at all, I have explained to you. Stillness cannot be changed, I explained to you. Voidance principle, explained to you also. And I have explained to you also. No. I want to come to one. Desire of mine. So that's very interesting. to take something like this. That's enough. To make two conical shapes. That is one, and that is the other. That is full improvisation right now. And you imagine, on the smallest and the biggest scale, only what you have in the universe is so simple. You have from one side, one cone. Here is cathode, divided, and here, and compressed, and here in the middle. They meet and create matter. And that matter here then expands equatorially back and compress again here and again here. And that is all what happens in the universe. That's easy. Excuse me, it was for the cakes, but I used it here for this demonstration. For the sake of simplicity, you understand it now. The whole universe is made just of those cones on the smallest scale, from atom to the biggest, biggest scale of nebulas, of whatever you have in the universe, is always the same principle of creation. Only this one principle. We want simplicity. We don't like to complicate. So, there are those people who don't like to be aware of it. And they deny to become aware. And that is why it is your mission, it is my mission, it is mission of all of us who are coming into the truth to spread out the truth. And I gave here some definitions and recommendation. Be wise. So stupid is one who continues to deny, refuse, and remain egoistically uninformed. That is what is stupidity. Ignorant is one who simply has not allowed the ability to come into the knowledge. Because it is omnipotent being. Every one of us is omnipotent being. If you allow yourself to come into the knowledge, knowledge then comes to you, like all of you who are now here. And wise is the one who realizes his ignorance and learns the knowledge. That's a simple, but it's true, of course. So, those guys made an experiment according to their belief system, and we don't care about it. They are not going crazy about it. And they are scientists, they are also people. It was just an experience. We love them. We love them. They are our brothers. And we place to the very end just two pictures. One is the man's way of placing the mirrors and experiencing one direction of rotation as an opposite one in the mirror, the placing the mirror here parallel to the shaft of the rotation. That is how we place our mirrors. And see in the mirror, you see this direction as the opposite one. But the nature places its mirrors light. This parallel to the direction of rotation and has the same direction. So, nature knows the truth, mind knows the truth, and we see it opposite. So since we are mind, we know the truth, and that is the main conclusion. All is well and perfect in all of the creation, and so it is.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. I'm really glad for your participation, for this explanation. And we continue in the half an hour pause, and then you will get information about how to create with conical coils and details and everything else what you are interested in, because you are practical creators. We drink one coffee and then I continue.